Hello everyone, my name is Prabir and a warm welcome to you. Today's session is aimed at giving an update on the modernization journey of IBM Security Verified Governance suite of products. We have three speakers today, Amit, Charles, Runmai. I will now hand over to Amit to continue today's topic.
My name is Amit, and I welcome each one of you. Our agenda today will guide us through key topics and discussions, ensuring a structured and insightful session. We will cover first overview of IBM Security Verify portfolio. Then we will cover IBM Security Verify governance, strategic focus areas, and key release details. Moving next, we will introduce the new containerized identity manager, along with its benefits and the deployment details, followed by a demo. Finally, we will cover the latest ISVG modernized end user experience, along with new certification campaign capabilities, and followed by a demo as well. Let's talk about the Verify portfolio. So IBM's Identity as a Service IDaaS solution, IBM Security Verify SaaS, helps organizations modernize and achieve hybrid identity and access management, which we call it as IAM implementations, while along also providing lightweight governance from the cloud. It includes consumer identity and access management, which we call it CIAM capabilities as well, to help build the backbone of a customer identity strategy. For organizations with the need of on-premise solutions, they can leverage IBM Security Verify Access. It can serve advanced access management use cases while also fitting consumer identity use cases. IBM Security Verify Governance includes robust identity governance capabilities as an on-premise solution. The IBM Security Verify Privilege offering, which includes both software as a service and on-premise deployment options to secure privileged user accounts. On this slide, we are talking about the strategic focus areas and key releases for the past couple of years for ISVG, which is IBM Security Verify Governance. So as you can see, ISVG follows a continuous delivery model. Releases happen in a quarterly schedule and consists of one or more of the following, right? So it could be field APAs, security fixes, research, enhancements requests, and the currency updates supporting new databases, directory servers, platforms, and all. In the next one, here we see the ISVG's latest version, which we delivered several new features which are useful for customers. So IBM Security Verify Governance Identity Manager is being constantly enhanced with more features to help customers address their new requirements. The end user UI has a new look and feel that is consistent with IBM's Carbon framework across all Verify portfolio. It allows easy navigation and helps end users and managers to perform their self-service tasks faster. The workflow and form designer in admin console used deprecated applet technology. This not only required JRE to be installed on the client machine and the browsers to support it, but also caused security risks. These designers were redeveloped using the latest technologies, and the dependencies on applets were removed. Moving further, loading the data from an HR system to Identity Manager and keeping them in sync is one of the most basic and common use cases at many customers. The out-of-the-box solution was limited to running SDI-based feeds. To ease the integration with popular HR systems like Workday, SAP, PeopleSoft, etc., Identity Manager now supports a new group of adapters called HR adapters. One needs to load the profile and create a service similar to other target adapters. The recon operation would pull the user data from the HR system and create person entities in Identity Manager. Moving this, strong authentication is one of the basic requirement of any system. Identity Manager supports OIDC-based authentication, thereby enabling integration with wide variety of OIDC providers like Verify Access, IBM Security Verify, Azure, etc. Once integrated, strong authentications like authenticator-based MFA, passwordless, adaptive, all these can be adapted enabled on the providers to protect login to Identity Manager. Moving next, this is our key news containerized identity manager offering, which got released in Q3 late last year. We are excited to announce the latest and the greatest containerized release of this premier identity management tool tailored for a seamless and secure user experience. This cutting edge version is Docker ready, simplifying deployment and scalability for enterprise IT systems. It's leveraging container technology. The new releases guarantee smooth integrations with existing infrastructure, reducing the time required for installation and configuration. Our tool now supports multi-tenant architecture, facilitating efficient identity management for organizations with multiple subdivisions groups. Enhanced security features are incorporated, including state-of-the-art encryption and sophisticated intrusion detection systems, fortifying user data protection measures. Improved microservices architecture, ensuring fault isolation, high availability, and resilience to achieve an uninterrupted service. We have added support for integration with popular continuous integration, continuous deployment, which we call it as CI/CD tools, making updates and rollbacks more streamlined than ever. We have upgraded our UI UX for a more intuitive and user-friendly interface, making identity management a breeze. Comprehensive logs and monitoring dashboards have been introduced to help you stay on top of your identity management. The containerized release of our identity management tool signifies our commitment to driving innovation, optimizing ease of use, and bolstering security for our users. The next one, I will just briefly touch about what I just mentioned about the new containerized identity manager, mentioning the benefits of containerization. So container form factor addresses a lot of challenges and pain points based on software stack and virtual appliance form factors. Firstly, it's easy to deploy and run on any cloud platform as it supports cloud native services. The identity manager code now runs on lightweight Liberty profile as opposed to the earlier deployment patterns which used to run on WebSphere ND. This has not only made the product lightweight, but also increased the performance and the boot up time. Scaling up and scaling down the nodes in response to high demand is now faster as the underlying Kubernetes cluster provides this feature. With WAS ND based deployments, scaling up and down the nodes was cumbersome. Since most of the deployment components are pre-built into the images, applying the patches and upgrading is pretty fast and less prone to errors. Containerization strategy is consistent across IBM Verify portfolio and all other products support container form factor. This makes it easier to co-deploy and integrate. Covering more on the deployment details, Identity Manager, the containerized version, can be deployed on a wide range of platforms. Software stack form factors can be installed on Windows servers and Unix-based OS running on a dedicated hardware or virtual machines. Virtual appliances are supported on wide range of hypervisors, like example, VMware ESX, Microsoft Hyper-V servers, Red Hat KVMs or Citrix hypervisors. And the container form factor, which we have been talking about, is supported on any Kubernetes-based orchestrator. It is even supported on popular cloud platforms like AWS and IBM Cloud. The product is also listed on AWS Marketplace.
My name is Mrunmayee and I welcome each one of you. Besides containerization part, what have we delivered with the Identity Manager? We have a lot of exciting features which are focused around the modernized user experience. This is one of the key element where we addressed is the strong authentication enabling users, admin users, as well as the IBM business users to log in using the QR-based technologies and other multi-factor authentication methods leveraging Verify SaaS. Another element is the feature of the Identity Service Center, like the access management for self-service, for others, activity management, profile management, batch request and custom tasks. All these tasks remain the same, however, with a new look and feel. There's another started addressing governance features as a part of the unified platform. That's really where the certification takes place. This is a feature probably you would not see into the software stack version or the virtual appliance. This feature is a solution to the use case of mitigating risk and addressing compliances by periodically certifying users, access entitlements, and accounts. Admin can create certification, assign reviewer supervisors who can supervise the certification campaigns periodically. The reviewer can review, approve, reject the request. There are emails sent, reports generated, which are similar to the other features in Identity Manager. Thank you.